Standing in your ruins feels a lot like the end. So used to losing, you're afraid to try again. Right now all you see are ashes where there was a flame. Truth is that you're not forgotten, 'cause grace knows your name.
God's not done with you.
Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars,
God's not done with you.
Even when you're lost and it's hard and you're falling apart,
God's not done with you.
It's not over, it's only begun. So don't hide, don't run, 'cause God's not done. There's a light you don't notice until you're standing in the dark. And there's a strength that's growing inside your shattered heart.
God's not done with you.
Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars,
God's not done with you.
Even when you're lost and it's hard and you're falling, it's not over, it's only begun. So don't hide, don't run, 'cause God's not done with you. You. He's got a plan, this is part of it. He's gonna finish what he started. He's got a plan, this is part of it. He's gonna finish what he started. God's not done writing your story. No, he's not done. God's not done with you.
God's not done with you.
Even with your broken heart and your wounds and your scars,
God's not done with you.
He's not done.
Even
with you,
you're lost and it's hard and you're falling apart,
God's not done with you. It's not. God's not done with you.
Hold on a little longer, it's almost the end. You're tired of losing, feel like you're never gonna win. Gotta go a little stronger and never give in. Because when you're falling down, he'll help you get up again. When you're falling down, he'll help you get up again.
Yeah, how long till this darkness passes? No beauty, man, all I'm seeing is ashes. I'm trying to climb, but I'm stuck at the bottom. One breath from drowning and sinking into this madness. Now I see my problems, never fight fair. Got me looking for the runway. Yeah, feeling like I'm in a nightmare. Man, I know I gotta wake up someday. I heard buddy I know telling me that they praying. Lot of words, but I don't really hear what they saying. Long days I suffer, dark days like thunder. I've been treading water, but I'm about to go down and under.
Hold on a little longer, it's almost the end. You're tired of losing, feel like you're never gonna win. Gotta go a little stronger.
All of this pain is like I can't catch a break, afraid. Holding on, but I don't know how much longer. I can feel my fingers slipping away. Dang. Now I'm feeling so frustrated. Why's it always so complicated? I just don't know if I can take it. I am breaking. When you need some help, trouble all around you, feeling like you're lost, just look to the one who found you. Was down, but he rose up again, and the same power that did that lives in you, so just keep
fighting.
Hold
on a little longer.
Hold on.
It's almost the end.
Trust me, I promise.
You're tired of losing, feel like you're never gonna win. Gotta go a little strong.
Hey guys, welcome again to Juniper live stream chapel. And why don't we stand again like last week? I know it's a little of a hassle sometimes, but it's better when we stand up and worship the Lord. So why don't we stand up and worship the Lord? Lord, I lift your name on high.
I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
One more time.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises.
I'm so glad.
I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
Okay, why don't we sing again? Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high.
You came from heaven.
You came from heaven to earth to show.
And I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands. For I will always sing of when your love came down. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love forever. I could sing of your love. Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me. And I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands. For I will always sing of when your love came down. I can sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love. Love forever. I can sing of your love forever.
I know. But when the words seem to lie, they will dance with joy. I will dance now. I could sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever. I can sing of your love forever.
Okay, you guys may sit down and let's sing our last song.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never fading. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a savior, the hope of nations. Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Time, everyone needs compassion.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a savior. God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Shine your light in, let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light in, let the whole world see. Singing for the glory of the risen King. Savior, He can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Ever author of salvation, He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave.
Okay, you may sit down. Why don't we pray together? Dear God, thank you for this day. Just thank you for this time. Thank you for letting us come together and worship you. This week's been pretty crazy. There's been the virus increasing and a big typhoon that went by a day ago. But we continue to believe you and trust you during these hard times. Just guide us and give us wisdom throughout the remaining week, and bless Miss Joyce for her upcoming sermon. In Jesus' name we pray.
morning, JCS students. Welcome to another chapel here live streaming on our YouTube channel. Today is August 28th, and we are already into our third week, our third academic week of 2020 fall semester. You've all done a wonderful job. We also want to remind you to be careful and to be safe and healthy during this time of COVID-19. We want to remind you that we have a sanitary and clean campus, and it is important for you to also self-manage yourself by washing your hands, using your hand sanitizers, wearing your mask, as well as your face shields. This is the schedule for our associated student body. Our application deadline actually falls on today. So if you are a high school student and you are looking to send your application in, please do not forget. All right. Please, and also look forward to our student body speeches that will take place on September 11th on Friday through this channel as well. We also have a new addition to our chapel. We would love to invite some students, middle school and high school students, to volunteer to lead body worship during our chapel rotations. And this will require for you to commit maybe 2-3 times throughout the semester to practice and to lead worship instead of Mr. Micah. You'll be on rotation. You'll be able to gain leadership skills, volunteership skills, as well as community service hours. We have about 6 positions open for our students. So please, if you're willing to serve and to lead, come talk to me or come talk to Mr. Micah. Our open house for fall 2020 falls on September 5th. It will take place at 11 a.m. on Saturday, also on our YouTube channel live stream. Don't forget to register now. Lastly, I'd like for everyone to be reminded that we need to take more time throughout this week and the next week to pray for the world, to pray for God's protection over all of the nations, and also for our campus to be continually safe, for us to continue our education, for the progression of the COVID-19 vaccine, and for us to all come to the Lord with this recommitment. Now we have our very special Miss Joyce Kong coming and sharing her message to you. Stay tuned.
Mommy, I'm so scared and worried because of coronavirus. I hear more and more people are being infected by it, and even the people around our town, our neighbors, are confirmed. You know Merity? Her aunt's friend got infected, and so her aunt has to be quarantined by herself because they ate dinner together the night before. That means it could be any one of us that could be infected by this virus anytime, anywhere. What if you and Dad got infected? And what if I get infected? What should we do? Joyce, my baby, calm down. Breathe in deep and breathe out. That's right. Oh, I know, I understand how stressful and fearful you feel because of what's happening around us right now. Even we adults like me, we become so stressed and worried from the rising cases of COVID-19. But if we only think about how scary it might be to be infected, then we're caught in the problem and cannot see anything that is good or that we can actually do.
What does that mean, Mom? What can we do? We can only stay home and not go anywhere.
It is important that we stay home and not go to places with a lot of people and wear masks all the time. However, there is more that we can do.
How could that be?
We can look at it with a bigger perspective.
Huh? What per super TV?
No. Perspective. It means to look at something with a certain point of view.
I still don't get it.
Hello? Oh, Freddie. Yes? Oh, I see. I'll go right ahead and buy some groceries for you. Don't worry.
What is it, Ma? Did something happen to Uncle Freddy?
Oh yes, just like Meredith's aunt, Uncle Freddy started quarantine since he went to the cafe where the confirmed case was reported today.
That's terrible, Mom. Will he be okay?
Joyce, come here. I know you're super worried, but God is with Uncle Freddy, and he is with all of us. Everything will be okay. So for now, I give you homework until I come back. You read one chapter from Exodus and work for 30 minutes on iReady lessons, okay?
Okay, Mom. I'll try to not worry so much. Hurry up and go. Uncle Freddy should be hungry.
Thank you, Joyce. Mom will only need about an hour, okay?
Be careful, Mom. Okay, I'll not worry. But listen to Mom and focus on what I should do now. Exodus. Where is my Bible? Where? Oh, here it is. But why does my Bible has principal's name, meaning holy? Oh, maybe this is that very famous, handsome Minho. Maybe not. I don't know. Dr. Lee? Why Dr. Lee's Bible at home? Maybe not. I don't know. Okay. So Exodus. Let me open. Okay. Exodus. I read chapter 15 yesterday. So today, 17. Oh, 16. No, 16. 16. 17. 16. 16. Oh. Hmm? What's this?
I see
a screen. In the Bible?
Oh, somebody's calling. Oh, what?
Hello?
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Oh, that person looks awfully familiar. Hello? Oh, who are you?
I thought you called me. Didn't you just open the Bible?
Oh, I did, but I wasn't expecting anyone to see, anyone to be there.
Well. I'm a very busy man. But when I have to accept a call, I do so to help. But I only see your eyes.
Huh? Oh, you only see my eyes. Oh, okay.
So who are you? I am Moses, you know? Moses. M-O-S.
Yes, of course. I know Moses from the Bible. The man who grew up as the prince of Egypt. The man who brought the Israelites out of Egypt. The man who followed the words of God. The man who talks with God. The man who received 10 commandments at the Mount of Sinai. Wow! You are that man?
Okay. I think you surely know me. That's me, little girl. What is your name?
I'm Joyce. Well, I don't understand. How can I talk to you in person? You lived long, long time ago.
Well, there are mysteries in this world. There must be a reason that you talk to me today.
You know what? This is great. I have so many questions to ask you.
Oh, you do? I hope I can be of help. But I'm pretty busy up here.
What were you doing there anyways? Is it a mountain? Why are you holding up your arms? I hear some noises in the background. You're not alone?
Oh, yes. I was very busy making sure that I hold up my arms so that Israelites would win over Amalekites.
What? There's a battle going on right now?
Well, it is true. The Lord said to hold up my arms at this hill. And the Lord will make our armies win over the enemy that just came over to fight with our people.
Whoa, that sounds exciting, but also scary. Are the Israelites okay?
Yes, they're winning, just like God has told us and promised us.
Oh, that's great. Wait a minute, as I read the Bible, I see that you guys just came out of Egypt.
Oh, yeah, that's true. We just came out of Egypt not so long ago.
Wow, I want to hear the whole story. I mean, I read the Bible and watched lots of movies and animation videos about it, but here you are. You're the real person. I want to hear all about it from the real person.
Oh, well, okay. Let me...
Oh, is something happening?
I put my arm down and my people are being beaten up and losing the battle. Oh no.
Oh my, that's not okay. Hurry up and hold up your arms. I'm so sorry. I don't have to hear your stories right now. I hope I can help you hold up your arms, but...
That's okay, little girl, that's okay.
I'm not a little girl. I'm a big girl. I'm Joyce.
Okay. Big Joyce.
But Grandpa Moses, I think you need help. You seem to have a hard time holding that arm up high by yourself for this long.
Don't worry. I do have faithful and very sincere people, partners in the Lord. Aaron, Hur, come, please help me. Oh yes, we are winning again, and that's it. Oh, go Israel, let's go. Oh, go Joshua, go. Go God, go. Oh.
Yeah, are they really winning? Really? Oh, that's amazing. You're just holding your arms up. God is really powerful. Go Israelites, go. Go Joshua, go. Go. And go God. Yay, go.
Yes, Israelites have won the battle. Thank you, Lord.
Hooray, victory is the Lord's.
That's right, Joyce. Victory belongs to the Lord. I'm so relieved and happy. Oh, praise the Lord.
You've done hard work, Grandpa Moses. But it is awesome how God lets you just hold your arms up even though you're the leader. You are not fighting at the battle scene, but you just had to listen and obey God's word and hold up the arms as you prayed. I really think that's amazing and unbelievable.
That is true, Joyce. I just listened and obeyed, and He gave us this victory. Oh, this is great. It is all by God that we are able to win and survive.
I was just reading the Bible and learned from Sunday school. I always thought you were the hero, the greatest leader. I mean, you are wonderful and great, but...
What? You thought I'm a hero? Oh, an old man like me. I said no to God when He told me to first go to Egypt and bring out the Israelites.
Oh, I remember that part from the Bible. I just finished reading that part last week. Were you scared then?
Well, I was not that happy when I first heard God calling me to go to Egypt and save Israelites by burning bush.
Oh yeah, that part, the burning bush. I colored that picture at our Bible class. Dr. Lee let us also make that scene with jumping clay, and I made the best one. Everyone said that mine looks the best, like real.
That must have been really fun. It is a great honor to have someone from long time ago or long time later to make my statue with something called, what was it called? Jumping clay? Clay is jumping?
Well, yeah, we little kids love to play with it and make many different things with that clay. Well, anyways, so the burning bush, how was it?
It was stunning. The bush was on fire. But it was not burning, you know. Oh, it was fire, but not burning. You know what I mean?
Huh?
I was actually scared.
No way. That's not true. You're just kidding. You weren't scared. You're my hero. You're the great leader. You would not be scared. No, you're just kidding.
Well, I must say, I should be honest. I was scared and fearful.
Do you really mean it?
Yeah, for sure. I really mean it. I was scared and I just did not want to go to Egypt. I did not want to go back there. You know, I grew up there as a prince. I was Pharaoh's boy. But I killed that one Egyptian because I was so angry. You know, that Egyptian just almost killed my Israelite. That was of my own blood. And then I was so angry at that moment. I never wanted to go back. I never wanted to be found out. I never wanted to be caught. I was scared. I was just...
Grandpa Moses, are you okay? I never thought you'd be in that situation. I just thought of it as a really simple thing. But now I hear it, you must have been scared. But you did come out and made it happen.
Yes, I did. Not because I was capable. I was able to do it. All of that because of God. God is God. He is the one who made it happen. I was just following His order and His word.
That really sounds wonderful. You know, to be honest, I'm really scared too. Do you know how the world has gone in the wrong way these days?
What do you mean? You seem to be in peace at home. You look like you're just safe and sound.
No. People here are all scared of something called COVID-19. Well, I'm really worried about it because my uncle might have been infected. I really hope no one around me gets infected. Our school is having classes together, but we might even have online class soon since the whole country is alarmed.
What is it? Online? Somebody's on the line? Somebody's walking on the line? What is this online thing?
Oh, no, Grandpa Moses. I think you won't understand what that is. I hope I can explain what it is, but...
Moses, we won the battle! Come down! Hooray! Praise the Lord!
Oh, it's time to go. I need to go now.
Oh, Grandpa Moses, I really want to talk to you more, but I have to let you go.
Well, Joyce, don't forget.
Yes?
Remember to look at everything in God's perspective.
Whoa, that's exactly what my mom said. That word, perspective.
Yes, that's the word. Oh, as a child, as a man himself, I mean myself, as a human being, we all cannot fully understand and control what's happening in this world. And we become really worried and scared and because we don't know what's going to happen around us.
That's right. I'm scared because I don't know what's going to happen. I'm afraid that we might all get sick or die.
That's what and how we all are. We might get sick or die even. But if you only worry about being sick or being dead, then we cannot see or understand why we're here in this world.
Uh-huh. I agree. But then why are we here? Why do we even have this kind of disease?
It must be because our world is in sin.
I know. We all sin. I learned that from the Bible. That's why Jesus came to save us from our sin.
Oh, Jesus?
Yes, Jesus. You don't know who he is yet. You're the man in the Old Testament. Jesus is God's son. He comes to save us all. He comes to die for us all on the cross once and for all.
Oh, is that true? Is that real?
Oh, yes, that is really, really true. I believe because it's written in the Bible.
That a girl, you should trust the Bible, the Word of God. That's having God's perspective.
You mean what's written in the Bible is how God sees things?
That's correct. I don't have that thick Bible you're holding, but as I learned and experienced God, I sure know that He is good and He is loving.
That's so good to hear. I get scared sometimes thinking if God is even here when there are so many bad things like COVID-19 happening all around us.
God is true and God is real. I'm sure He is right there with you right now. Just like He is with me right now here and the Israelites right here, right now.
Okay, Grandpa Moses, I'll remember. Having God's perspective is to see things with God's eyes. I'll be able to do that when I believe and trust in His word. It is to know that God loves us and knows us.
Great! That's it!
Thank you, Grandpa Moses.
Sure thing. Today, I'm building an altar with the name, "The Lord is my banner." I want all of the Israelites to remember and know that the Lord gave us victory and won today's battle. But not only that, He is always fighting with us and with us.
I'll also remember that Grandpa Moses, the Lord is my banner. He is always fighting for us and with us.
Yes, Joyce, He is fighting for you and is with you, even in your difficulties with, what was it called? Oh, yes, COVID-19.
Thank you. I remember today's talk. I'll miss you.
Oh, I'll remember you in my prayers. I'll go right now to build an altar.
시간이 끊임없이 흐르지 그에 따라 난 내 발을 구르지 죽을 힘으로 달려도 죽을 지언적 절대로 땅에 내 무릎이 닿지 아니하게 할 거야 내 무릎은 오직 주님 앞에서만 꼬를 것이고 내 눈은 언제나 보이지 않는 미래를 재려봐 그대로 위한 내가 무엇을 해야 하나 그 해답에 첫 번째는 기도 두 번째는 펜을 쥐고 세 번째는 꿈을 꿔 네 번째는 힘없이 믿고 또 믿어 그리고 기대함으로 Just wait 그날의 시간을 지금 가져왔다 생각하고 행동해 밑바닥 이게 나의 현주소 두려움이 배로 생겨도 절대 난 멈춘 적 없이 달리고 있는 중 다른 이들이 만들어놓은 길이 아닌 내가 내 길을 만들어가기에 내 미래는 헤매야지만 헤매야지 내 시작점과 정반대라는 걸 세상이 알 수 없다는 걸 난 이렇게 불러 가능성 오늘도 내 빈잔을 더 계속 채워나가 매일 밤마다 꿈에 대한 열정으로 끝없이 태워 막나는 시간들을 되게 악한 게을른 산만해서 보낼 때면 항상 I break the mark I say the mark I please raise the mark my soul I'm a waste of mark과 시간을 지혜롭게 사용하면 정복해 이건 새로 만들어진 내일의 나라 위한 사명 아직 다들 몰라 내 이름 그렇기에도 크게 외치는 중 나는 오늘도 여전히 꿈조리는 태도로 자세는 낮게 눈은 항상 위로 오려 내가 나를 대표해 나왔어 목소리 높여 내 관이 짜여지기 전까지 내 꿈들을 겸멋지고 자만하는 놈의 겉에는 어데이니 플라스틱 서저리 언제나 시간을 아끼라던 나의 아버지와 어머니의 말씀이 날 일으키므로 지금의 내가 세워졌지 틱톡 시간이 나를 던져 틱톡 시기가 멈춰도 가는 시간에 틱톡 시간이 나를 던져 틱톡 시기가 멈춰도 가는 시간에 틱톡 goes on and on and on and on and on TikTok goes on and on and on and on TikTok goes on and on and on and on TikTok goes on and on and on TikTok on and on TikTok 시기가 멈춰도 가는 시간에 솔직히 말해 내가 가까워지는 건 지금 이 곡의 시작부터 생기는 몸에 미세한 주름 허나 시간이 가는 건 어쩌면 이 땅에서 내 꿈을 현실로 만들어주는 나를 위한 신의 present but 공짜인 것은 없지 so I get my ass up 가만히 있다가 미래에 내가 더 멀어지겠어 내 꿈에 개꿈해줘 라던 애들의 날 보면 여전히 놀라 너 17살 때부터 꽂았고 아직 포기도 않고 왜 있었냐 Yes, 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 my yellow, that's right 내가 맨날 책상 앞에 앉아서 랩할 때마다 들렸던 세상의 책망 그게 지금은 나를 만들고 내 꿈을 더 잘하게 했다 이제 계속해서 티내겠어 내 이름 B-E-W-H-Y 내 믿음의 향하는 길을 따르지 말하지 않는 내 상상을 실현하기 위해 I won't stop again Tryna keep all of my dream I'm a B-E-W-H-Y는 그동안 꿈꾸는 미래에 내가 바로 나의 워너비 내 미래를 이미 이룬 듯 믿을 수밖에 나 모든 걸 걸었기 And 내 선택은 절대로 많지 않지 Do or die 의심 가득했던 나는 신의 기억 원날 물어봐 내가 꾸는 꿈을 내 능력으로 갚을 수 있나고 희생 내가 다가풀 때니 넌 한도 없이 꿈을 꾸었다 Okay my Jehovah Make your body a bone 니라 생각 안 해 그의 약속은 항상 지켜지기 애무조건 믿어 그게 내가 발자국을 남기는 유일 하는 동네 혁신의 개발 안에서 믿음 아닌 능력 이게 내 slogan TikTok 시간 위에 나를 던져 TikTok 시기가 멈춰도 가는 시간 위에 TikTok 시간 위에 나를 던져 TikTok 시기가 멈춰도 가는 시간이 TikTok goes on and on and on TikTok on and on TikTok goes on and on and on TikTok on and on TikTok goes on and on and on TikTok on and on TikTok 시간은 간지 틱톡 그 시간 속에서 기도로 나는 매일 손을 모으고 하늘로 부르짖어 의심 대신에 확신을 두려울 땐 담대함이 늘 나에게 머물도록 내가 날카한 내 자신을 의지하는 것이 아닌 아버지 당신을 의지하게 날 세우소서 나는 아직까지 너무도 매비하게 그러나 매비한 만큼 창대하다는 것을 매치 현재 난 지금은 먼 미래지만 오늘이 되겠지 언젠가 모든 것을 당연히 여기지 않아 내가 여태 지나온 거리 위만을 발걸으면 나를 만들었고 하루 종일 빛나는 내 삶을 주신 주 함께 내 안개를 부셔버리 그날을 아름답게 맞이하기 위해서 바로 지금 여기에 서있지 나는 내 삶을 바로 신이 만들 예술 작품에 featuring 나의 불완전함을 사용하는 창조주의 심포니 나로 인해서 쓰여지는 위대한 history 어쩌면 이 모든 건 내 이야기가 아닌 history TikTok